Chelsea, we're up.
Saddle up.
Go.
What is it?
Commercial.
Slow burn. Okay.
Stop.
Got a flower shop, 2217 Sudbury, west of Manchester. 15 seconds to lift off. Moving out here.
Let's move it, chop, chop.
Aerial 16 on scene, A side, west side, heavy smoke showing.
It's our shop.
Anybody else inside?
No, it's just us.
This is Chelsea, our paramedic. She's gonna take care of you. Get them back away from the building, okay?
Got it.
I got O2.
I just heard this pop in the cold storage unit, and there was suddenly all this smoke, but no flames.
Hey, no unusual redness. It's good.
We got out of there fast. Smart. You ladies crawl out?
No.
Okay. Well, if you're ever in that situation again, hit the floor, get on your hands and knees. Most casualties in a fire happen with smoke inhalation, but you don't see that coming.
Let's go around back. Lots of smoke.
Sounds good. You ladies sit tight, all right? All right, thank you. Oh, here we come.
You got lucky. Fire's in the flower storage unit, but we contained it there.
So there's no fire damage?
Well, the compressor's toast. And that ethylene couldn't be good for your flowers, but it's no structural damage.
Great. Just what we need with Valentine's Day around the corner.
At least you're safe.
Nice. Thank you.
Are you Dan Farrell?
Yeah.
Wendy. Wendy Clark. You were in my big brother's class at Chatham High.
Stephen Clark. How many years has it been?
Oh, let's not do that math. This is my business partner, Kate Burlingham.
Hi.
Sorry about the circumstances. Pleasure to meet you.
Me too. Thank you.
Hey. Say hi to Steven, all right?
Yeah, yeah.
Saddle up, fellas. Get back to the shop.
Shall we face the music?
I don't think we have a choice. Dan Farrell. Such a great guy in high school. Found out at a reunion that his wife died a few years ago.
Oh.
Laura Holloway, she was in my brother's class too.
That is so awful.
Yeah, can't imagine.
Hey, Dad!
You're reading the Mercenary Fables?
Well, Bettina.
Do you play the game?
Constantly.
Because the books don't make any sense if you don't.
On my phone, my notebook, and my computer.
But what about the cloud version?
It's on the cloud now?
Yeah, since Friday.
Shut up!
It's the best yet. Majorly interactive.
I'm so gonna hook into that.
Ah, good, you're here. Hey. How was the bus ride?
Long and boring.
I know, why do they have to make so many stops?
Right, I mean, seriously, every corner.
Do you go to Central?
Parkview.
Ah, who do we have here?
Hey, my daughter, Rebecca. Rebecca, Lieutenant Farrell.
Nice to meet you, Rebecca. I see that you've met my son, Tyler.
That's your son. Wow. Hey, Chelsea.
Hi.
Hey.
You guys on your way back from a fire?
Small one, compressor fire.
So you didn't get to break out the hoses?
No need. Never got rolling.
That's too bad.
Gotta watch out for those fires, though. Because sometimes the toxic gases are more dangerous than the flames.
Oh, cool.
So, who was that lady? You know, with the daughter?
She's one of our new EMTs.
New? She seems kind of old to me.
Well, she's new to us. I knew her from when she worked emergency over at the hospital.
And her daughter? Is she going to be coming by after school, like, every day?
Why? Is she a pain?
Oh, no. She's okay. You know, for a girl.
Get in the house. Come on.
I can't believe we have to shut down less than 2 weeks before the biggest day of the year.
I know. But look on the bright side. For once, you can actually enjoy Valentine's Day.
I have a husband with a one-track mind. Enjoying Valentine's Day has never been a problem.
Are you complaining?
No, not even. How about you? Big plans for the romantic day?
Absolutely. I actually have 2 dates lined up.
Really?
Brad Pitt and Colin Firth? Provided there isn't a video streaming meltdown.
Well, I don't know. Single women, Valentine's Day. It could be the perfect broadband storm. Seriously, ask somebody out. Show yourself a good time.
Well, I plan on having an excellent time. Did I not mention ice cream cake with gumdrop hearts? I'm good.
Oh, we need to get you back into circulation. No. It's selfish to keep all this wonderfulness to yourself.
Oh, well, maybe I'll join you and Nick.
Or plan B, and we get you a date.
Fine, Wendy. Fine.
Bam. Oh, well, you just played the wrong card, buddy. Bam! You just got served Queen of Spades.
Settle down, Magnum. Read 'em and weep.
You didn't keep a heart?
Yeah, I was trying to protect my hand.
How'd that work out for you?
Yeah, how'd that work out?
So good. You know, I don't see why it's gotta be me, guys.
Seriously, we've done this over and over again.
Because you're single. Dan is single.
You're the young stud muffin, okay? They're gonna eat you up.
That's what I don't like about it, Dan. I feel like a commodity.
Poor baby.
No, seriously, want a date with one of our bravest?
What's wrong with that?
It's demeaning.
It's for a good cause. Think about the kids.
Do it for the children.
What about if she wants to go to, I don't know, the opera or something on her?
She?
Look, it's a tradition, okay? And a big moneymaker. Just enjoy the fact that you're still young and bankable.
Yeah. See? A commodity.
Welcome to my world, girlfriend.
Hey, guys.
Hey, dude. How's school?
Great.
By the way, I win.
That's the battle, not the war.
Yeah, let's go. We gotta clean the rig. Can't put that off for another day. Chop, chop.
Hey.
Yeah, okay.
Is Rebecca here?
Nah, she's at Taekwondo.
She does Taekwondo?
Yeah, she's working on a red belt.
That's... wow.
Hey, you, taking a date to the ball this year?
Me?
Yeah.
Why does everybody keep asking about that?
Well, because my sister just came through a messy divorce.
Wait, Serena?
Huh? Ooh-wee. She is hot.
Hard to believe they're from the same gene pool, huh?
Hey, you telling me. Now, come on, I'm serious. Like, invite her to the ball, turn on that Feral Charm, and make her feel sexy again.
What Feral Charm?
Hey, Joey, if he's not interested, I'm your guy. She doesn't date adolescents.
Rinse.
I'm a grown man.
Hey!
Rinse.
That's it. You can't date my sister.
Hey, is it my imagination or are these jackets getting smaller?
Never too late to say no to carbs.
Hey, Chelsea.
Hey, Dan. Well, do you have a sec? That time clock. I'm still having trouble with it.
That's still acting up?
Yes.
Come on.
Hey, Tyler.
Hey.
Excuse?
You finished?
Yeah, I got some homework.
I thought you did that at the firehouse.
Well, I couldn't do all of it.
Hey, whoa. Don't throw that out. I thought you loved my carbonara.
Oh, yeah, it was great. It's just, I'm not that hungry.
You're not hungry? Is that even possible?
I guess so.
You all right?
Yeah, I'm fine.
What's up?
You texted me earlier. Help with your math homework?
Yeah. Just let me get my books.
So we'll be in chapter 8, page 84.
Thanks a lot.
You're welcome.
Welcome to Danby's. This week, our special is on baby back ribs. Only $5.99 per pound. See what happens when the best florist in town closes? People are forced to buy their flowers at the grocery store.
Kate.
Yeah. Dan, right?
Yeah. They had to shut you down?
Just until the insurance comes through so we can fumigate and restock.
Of course.
How are you?
Oh, well, I'm great now because I'm with an expert and I don't know the first thing about flowers.
Well, at least you're trying. I mean, I'm sure your girlfriend appreciates the effort.
The firehouse is doing its annual fundraiser and it's a Valentine's Day ball and I'm sort of the decorating committee. I'm here doing a little research.
What are you raising money for?
It's a scholarship fund for the children of fallen firefighters.
That's amazing. You know what? Don't get your flowers here. Go to Carney's.
What's Carney's?
It's the best flower market in the state, and it's only 20 minutes from here, up Highway 27.
Let me write that down. 27?
Yeah. Okay. Except Carney's is a wholesaler, and you need a florist license to shop there.
Oh, bummer.
I have a license.
I don't want to ask you to do that.
No, you're not asking. I'm offering. It'll be my contribution to the fundraiser.
Sure.
Yeah.
Great, because I could use all the help I could get.
What kind of arrangements did you have in mind?
Do I look like I know?
Tell you what, why don't you show me the venue and we can figure it out?
Sure, that's not asking too much?
No. I mean, Dan, flowers are my business, and I'm temporarily out of a job, so use me.
Okay, I will.
I'll just give you my number so you can call me whenever you want to go see the venue.
Perfect.
Great. Great to see you.
Yeah, you too.
Bye.
The mall near your school? Yeah, I don't see why not. Your dad and I were planning to go see a movie, so we'll just see one there. That'll give you a couple hours, okay? All right, sweetie. I love you. Bye. Hey, Tyler.
Kay?
Hey.
Was that Rebecca?
Yeah. You know, that girl would spend all weekend at the mall with her friends. You know, they don't even buy stuff. They just walk around and hang out.
That's kind of weird.
Yeah. That's kind of girl. I did the same thing when I was her age. We're not like you, Tyler.
Yeah, I noticed.
What do you need to get?
I don't need to get anything.
Why go to the mall if you're not going to buy something?
Well, my dad said he could take us, and
it'll be fun.
Okay.
I still think it's kind of lame.
Whatever.
Well, when we had it here last year, the DJ booth was here in the corner, and the buffet was back here against the wall. The bar was over here in the back room, and we had tables all around.
Oh, okay. Do you want arrangements on every table?
Sounds great.
Maybe a garland around the bar?
Whatever you think. Oh, by the way, we have to make sure we decorate the auction block.
Auction block?
Yeah.
This Valentine's Day ball just got a little more interesting.
We auction off a date with one of our single firefighters. It is very popular with the ladies.
I bet it is. Are you on the block this year?
Me? No, 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 just for the younger guys.
Right, because you're way too old.
My son seems to think so.
How old's your son?
Tyler's 12.
Is he your only child?
Mm-hmm.
Wendy told me about your wife. I'm very sorry.
Thank you.
It'll be great.
Yeah. This is it.
It's a beautiful space.
Yeah. And how do you know that he doesn't have a girlfriend?
He kind of told me.
Why would he kind of tell you?
I maybe fished a little.
You like him.
Come on, he's a firefighter, for crying out loud. And not exactly hard on the eyes.
No, ma'am, not hard on the eyes at all.
So what's not to like?
Ladies and gentlemen, Kate Burlingham is back. Okay. The blood is flowing. There's a definite uptick in the heavy breathing department. And I think we've even detected a pulse. Thank you, Dan.
Top it. I am helping him with the flowers for his fundraiser.
Of course you are, because you're not a woman. You're a philanthropist. Okay. Well, seeing as you're back from the dead, give me your opinion on something. Which of these two outfits do you think would look sexier on me?
I don't think there's enough fabric to qualify as outfits.
Ugh. Just trying to surprise Nick for Valentine's Day.
I think you'll be plenty surprised with either one of them, and then some. You really love Nick, don't you?
Yeah. Well, that's why I married him. You were right to draw a line in the sand, Kate.
You didn't have to draw a line in the sand with Nick.
Not overtly. Subtly, I did. I mean, I think that's what women do. We just nudge guys in the right direction. Mm-hmm. I mean, let's face it, it usually takes them longer to commit than us.
So maybe I should have given Gavin more time.
You gave him plenty of time. Why are we even talking about Gavin? Let's talk about Dan. And what you're gonna wear when you see him next.
Something with plenty of fabric.
Ah, right. It's only your second date.
We are not dating. Dessert?
Right, reveal yourself slowly in layers, like an onion.
Is this your idea of fun? Walking around all day? It's good exercise. And we're not even walking that fast. Come on, let's go.
I get plenty of exercise.
Well, you know, there's actually people who come to the mall to exercise. They, like, do laps around it in groups.
Yeah, and you know what they call those people? Geezers.
Okay, fine. We'll go in a few minutes. Only if we don't...
Don't what?
Weren't we supposed to meet your dad, like, 20 minutes ago?
You want me here because of girls?
Where are you, buddy? It's 3:50. Call me when you get this.
Her name's Rebecca. My dad works with her mom.
Are you, like, into her?
I don't know. I guess.
Gross. What do you mean?
What should I say to her?
How should I know?
Oh, man. This is creepy. Stop. It's really...
Excuse me! What's the story? You were supposed to meet me at the mall entrance at 3:30. I've been calling.
You have?
Yes.
Sorry. I forgot to turn it on.
Forgot to turn it on. You. You think I'm buying that? What's with you these days?
I'll tell you what's with him.
Is that, Chelsea's daughter?
He was just here. Now he won't even talk to her.
Let's just go.
I mean, how lame was that?
So you like Rebecca?
I don't even know her.
Get to know her. Ask her to be a Facebook friend.
That'd be like stalking her.
Kind of like today? I'm kidding. You know, I was right around your age when I met your mother.
Can we not talk about this?
You know, you want some intel on how to get to know Rebecca, take it from your old man. I've been there, done that. No? Nothing? You got nothing for me? Okay.
Okay, so the thing is, when I first met Rebecca, it was like super easy to talk to her because she was, you know, just this person. Now it's like I just keep hoping that she'll come to the station after school every day. And at the same time, I'm scared because, well, what am I going to say to her?
Well, what did you talk about the first time?
You know, books, the cloud, buses.
Okay. What else is she into?
She's into Taekwondo.
Dude, that's perfect. You have that in common.
I know. How awesome is that?
That's pretty awesome. That's what you talk about. You get it? That's what you talk about. Okay. Try to find something to do outside the firehouse.
You mean like a date?
Yeah. Taekwondo date.
Okay.
Hi, Wendy.
Hey, Kate. You figured out what you're gonna wear tomorrow?
Something with plenty of fabric.
Oh, double down, Kate. You got a shot at a great guy here. You need to use every weapon in your arsenal.
Wendy, getting to know someone isn't an act of war.
Oh, I recommend something in red.
You look fabulous in it, plus it sends a subliminal
let me be your Valentine message.
Good night, Wendy.
Double down, Kate, double down.
Good night.
Hey, guess who's here? Give it your best shot, kid.
Hey, Tyler.
Hey, Rebecca. How's it going?
Going great.
Good. It's good. So, your mom told me that you were into Taekwondo.
Oh, yeah, big time.
Well, there's this 3D movie playing. The Korean national team.
Right, doing demonstrations. I read about that.
Yeah. Wednesday being a half day and all, I was thinking of going to see it after school.
Cool.
Does Parkview do half days on Wednesdays?
Yeah, I think that's district-wide.
Huh. Well, if you're not doing anything after school on Wednesday, I was thinking maybe we could go together.
That'd be totally awesome.
Okay.
Did you always want to be a fireman?
Sometimes I think the whole fireman thing was just part of the way it was supposed to be, you know? I mean, I met Laura when I was just a kid, and then everything fell into place. You know, sweetheart, family, job. We had a full life together, over 20 years. Better than most couples these days.
That's a very sweet way of looking at it. Isn't it dangerous? Firefighting?
It can be. I mean, my station never lost anybody or had any serious injuries, but some of the others around town, you know, they haven't been so fortunate. How about you? How did you get started in the flower business?
Well, believe it or not, I have an MBA.
Impressive.
Top of my class, no less.
Very impressive.
Yeah, I set my sights high. I was going to be CEO of something. By the time I was 40. 6 months into my first corporate job, I came home from yet another soul-destroying networking party, and I looked myself in the mirror and said, Kate, what do you really want? Because it is not this.
What was your answer?
That I wanted to do something that made me happy. And flowers make me happy. So I took everything I learned about big business, applied it to small business, and never looked back.
Laura loved flowers. She used to have arrangements like this, you know, all around the house.
And none of that rubbed off on Mr. I don't know anything about flowers.
It was her thing. I just, you know, love that I made her so happy.
Oh, Well, I'll put together some samples and drop them by.
I'm sure whatever you come up with will be great.
I will do my best.
Thank you.
No, it was my pleasure.
What's with all the softball swag?
Well, now that I got some time on my hands, I'm trying to get my swing back. I'm actually heading to the field now to take a couple of hacks.
You play?
I'll stay in high school, but I don't like to brag.
You don't understand. The firefighters have a co-ed softball league. We never have enough women. You've got to play.
Sign me up.
You don't play first base, do you?
I'll stay in high school, and maybe I do like to brag.
Where have you been all my life?
How often are you supposed to change those things?
About once a year.
Hey, I got a new slope. Check it out. You're going to love this. Show her you love her on Valentine's Day. Change the battery in her smoke detector. Pretty good, huh? What, you don't like it?
Seems kind of unromantic.
Protecting the life of somebody you love? Please. What's more romantic than that? Speaking of romance, what time is this movie you're going to tomorrow?
3:30.
Okay, perfect. I want you to take the bus over to the mall. I'll pick you up after work, okay?
Okay. So, aren't you supposed to bring a girl something on a first date?
What'd you have in mind?
I don't know, like candy or flowers.
Yeah, it sounds kind of Archie and Betty to me.
Who?
Oh, wait. I've got a great idea. Make her a mixtape.
What's that?
Come on, are you kidding me? It's when you put all your favorite songs on one of those, what do you call, you know, the MP3 playlist.
Of songs I like?
Yeah.
What if she thinks I stink?
Well, then you ask her why and you figure out what song she does like, pal. Because that's all part of the process of getting to know each other. Hey, when I first met your mom, I made her a mixtape and I put Walk Like an Egyptian on it.
What?
Never mind. The point is, I was afraid she wasn't going to like it and she loved it. We used to sing it all the time. In fact, to the point where we kind of drove our friends crazy.
Oh, a tape!
Yeah.
You made her a video!
No, not a video.
It's a great idea! I'll make her a DVD of YouTube videos of songs I like. Thank you so much, Dad.
Okay. Well, that's what I'm here for.
Well, I can't fault his taste in girls, but my commanding officer's son. I don't know. What if she breaks his heart?
That'll make your life a living hell.
Right.
My costume's here, Michael.
What costume?
For the auction.
No. Nobody said anything about a costume.
It's a tradition.
Ladies love it.
Oh, yeah, no. We sure do. It's super sexy.
What's this?
It's called the Love God.
Cupid meets Hercules. No. I'm not wearing this.
Oh, but you must.
It's a commitment, Michael.
Not gonna happen.
There's more.
Hey, wait.
Oh, where are you going? Oh, come on.
No, I'm starting to hate Valentine's Day.
Can't take it. Yeah, baby.
Oh, no.
Remember that flying spinning hoe kick? That was awesome.
I didn't actually really catch that at all.
Well, it was over the guy's head. Then he did a roundhouse
to the cheek.
I didn't
see that. No.
Come on, you do this.
Is your mom?
Yep.
Whoa. That's my girl.
Bye.
Bye.
Yeah, okay. See you later, guys.
See you tomorrow.
She loved the movie. She loved the mix.
What'd I tell you?
And she said that we're gonna hang out at the softball game on Saturday.
It sounds like a date.
I guess so. Wow. Hey, Dad?
Yeah?
How come you don't date?
I don't know.
It's not because of me, is it?
No, son, please.
You know, like, because I miss Mom? And you don't have a girlfriend because you think I wouldn't like it? Like you were replacing Mom or something.
I don't have a girlfriend because the circumstances aren't right. You know, you have to meet the right
Dad.
Person. And
seriously.
Look, your mother and I had a full life, right? An amazing relationship for over 20 years, and that's more than I
Most
can say
couples
for...
these days. Yeah, I know. You always say that. But it couldn't have been that full. She didn't get to see me go to high school, learn to drive, start shaving, a million things.
Nope.
When you say you've already lived a full life, I feel like, I don't know, like I'm not there.
That
That's not what I meant by that, son.
I just wish you'd stop pretending to be so happy all the time.
I am not pretending.
Well, you have to be. At least a little, because we lost so much.
That's true. But we still have each other. And you, son, are the best part of your mother and me. You got that? Even if she won't get to see you shave.
All I'm saying is it's okay with me.
What?
You know, if you want to have a girlfriend.
So you're giving me permission?
Yeah, hey. But first you have to get a girlfriend. Come on, old man. Hurry it up.
Touch of the arm.
Oh, yeah? Because, Dan's doing the same thing.
Oh, so? The male reciprocates.
Yeah, why not? She's a babe.
What are you ladies gossiping about?
Dan's hitting on Kate. Not hitting on.
He's circling, testing the waters, putting in signals.
Why not? She's great.
Oh, yeah, she's a total babe.
That too.
Because Dan's never been into anyone. Never, except Laura.
Wow, he's got to get back out there, huh?
I just wanted to come and say goodbye.
Hey!
You'll be seeing her Saturday. We've got a new ringer on our softball team.
You play softball?
Allstate in high school.
Please tell me your first baseman.
Allstate.
Oh, why didn't your compressor catch fire sooner?
Sorry.
Sorry.
Yeah. By the way, you inspired me.
I did?
Yeah. Tomorrow I'm heading over to batting practice. Gonna take a couple of hacks.
Really? Why don't we go together? 3 o'clock?
Sounds great.
See you tomorrow.
Cool.
And I will see you Saturday.
See you Saturday.
Bye.
Bye.
What did I tell you?
Wow, you guys played that right.
What are you talking about?
You're into her.
She's a friend. I just met her.
Why are you going on a date?
I'm not. That's not a date.
Well, when a woman and a man go out and, you know, do stuff. That's a date, Dan.
In no known universe is batting practice a date.
It is in mine.
No, you're an ape. Get back to work.
All right, have one on your date.
Date.
You're an ape.
You gotta shut it down, buddy. Way past your bedtime.
Okay. Yeah, you heard that? Yeah, I gotta go. Yeah, you too. Okay. Okay, bye.
How's Alex doing?
Oh, that wasn't Alex. That was Rebecca.
Rebecca? What were you two talking about for over an hour?
Well, I don't know. Everything. So, I was wondering, you know this Valentine's Day ball?
Mm-hmm.
Is it just for grown-ups?
I don't know. I mean, no kids have ever wanted to go before.
Well, I do. And I want to bring Rebecca.
Well, it's $100 a pop. You got $200 stashed around here somewhere, I don't know?
Maybe you could advance my lawn mowing money.
That's 20 mows. That's like a 2-summer advance.
Well, you could charge me interest, right?
Tell you what. You just don't whine when I ask you to mow, you understand?
Okay.
Or make your bed.
Sure.
Or take out the trash.
Anything.
Or walk the dog.
We don't have a dog.
In case we ever get one. All right, deal?
Deal.
All right, lights out, come on, we got a big day tomorrow.
Ooh, wait, hey, what if she doesn't want to go?
Well, you better work that out before you buy the tickets.
Good thinking.
Yeah.
Thanks, Dad.
Okay. You know, I've been thinking about this conversation we had the other day about dating. I think I'm going to give it a shot. See how it goes.
Oh, you'll like it, Dad. It's pretty awesome.
That's what they tell me. Good night.
Good night.
Kate?
Hi, Dan. It's Kate.
I know. Caller ID.
Right. How are you?
I'm good. You?
Great. How was the rest of your day?
Day was good. Yours?
Great. It was really great.
So, what's up?
Tomorrow. Batting practice? The fields on the west side of town or the east?
East side. I'm sorry, I thought I had mentioned that to you.
You know what, you probably did. I'm just double-checking. 3 o'clock, right?
3 o'clock.
Great. I will see you then.
See you then.
Great.
Here it comes.
All right.
Show them where you live, kiddo. Nice! Whoa! Nice!
Kick their butts on Saturday, assuming we let you have every at bat.
Come on, you're a great hitter.
Thank you. Hey, I was wondering, since you've been such a big help with the ball and everything, and it's such an awesome night, I thought maybe you'd want to come with me, you know, as my date.
I'd love to.
Great. I wasn't sure, you know, if you had a boyfriend.
Full disclosure, I had a boyfriend. A serious one, but 5 months ago, he transferred to L.A., and we broke up.
I'm sorry.
It's okay.
Not really.
I haven't thought about dating anybody since he left. Until now.
So, it's a date?
It's a date.
Great.
I'll take my bag.
I'm sorry.
I'm really glad you asked.
See you Saturday.
It was a lot of fun. See you Saturday.
Okay. Bye.
Bye.
Hello, Dan.
Joey.
Date go well?
No. It was not a date, Joey, but it is now. Because I just asked her to the ball.
Seriously?
Yeah.
Okay, fine. We're dating. Yeah, in fact, I have to cancel Brad and Colin because I have a Valentine's Day date. The firefighter's ball. You are? Okay, great. I'll see you there. Yes, Wendy, of course I have you to thank. I doubled down. I doubled way down. Okay, bye.
Kate?
Kevin?
Kate Burlingham? Will you be my Valentine? Forever?
What are you doing here?
I'm here for you.
Why didn't you tell me you were coming?
I wanted to surprise you.
Oh, I'm surprised, all right.
Really? So, what do you say?
About what?
I just proposed to you.
I say I need to sit down. You just sit there, please.
Did you get a good look at the ring?
Kevin, what is this about?
It's about me loving you. I've always loved you.
Yeah, I loved you too. And we broke up, remember?
What I remember is a woman who wasn't willing to move to L.A. with me unless we were married, and a me who was too stubborn and set in his ways to ask her. But I am not that me anymore.
Well, maybe I'm not that woman anymore.
Is there somebody new?
Is there?
I'm seeing someone, sort of.
Define sort of.
He just asked me out on our first official date.
Okay, well, so there's still hope.
Gavin.
Letting you go was the biggest mistake I ever made. I screwed up. I know that now. And I'm willing to do whatever it takes to get you back. I want us back again.
I wasn't ready for this.
No, I know.
I think I just need to sort this out.
Okay, well, I mean, let me take you for dinner and we can talk this through.
No, not tonight. You broke my heart when you left. You know that, don't you?
I know. And I'm so sorry.
I think you should go.
Okay.
How long are you here for?
Well, until you say yes.
Did somebody say deep dish everything?
Sweet.
What are you working on there? Valentine's?
Yeah. I want to make one for Rebecca. For when I ask her out to the ball. I'm just looking for ideas.
Sweet. Let me get some plates.
All right.
Says he changed his mind. Realizes that he made a big mistake.
A little late in the game for that, don't you think?
Wendy, I keep telling you that this is not a game.
So you're thinking about taking him back? Kate, he had his chance and he blew it.
So I shouldn't give him a second one.
Do you want him?
I don't know. I really love the guy. I invested years into this relationship. Marrying him was part of the big plan.
Plans change.
I know. Except I don't know if the way I feel about him has.
Okay. Okay, hey, I get it. When you love somebody, you love them. I mean, me and Nick went through a thing.
You did?
Back in the day. We sorted it out, and I guess, I don't know, I'm sure it's just something that couples go through.
I am not sure about anything, believe me. I mean, I think I still love him, but I don't know if I can trust him not to let me down again. And then there's Dan.
You're in love with him, too?
No, I mean, we are just getting to know each other, but... He's pretty special, and being with him feels really nice.
Wow. A week and a half ago, your Valentine's Day date was Netflix. And now you have two real live guys to choose from.
I know. What am I gonna do?
I don't know. Well, for starters, some more of this.
That I can do.
Valentine, and won't you be my anytime? I got a little foolish heart and I don't know where to start, and all of my love is true. All that I need from you is that you be my Valentine. Just give me a sign that you will be my Valentine.
What's the matter?
Buster. We don't want her getting injured.
You rock, girl.
Ah! Damn right.
Would you like to go to the firefighter's ball thing?
Firefighter's ball. How cool would that be?
Yeah. Now look who it is.
Let's go, Kate.
Show them where you live, Kate. Show them where you live.
Let's go, Kate.
Tattoo on,
you
know. Tyler. Good.
As a matter of fact, don't touch her at all. Don't even hold her hand.
Come on, Kate!
Take one look at her. I can't promise anything.
Come on! Let's go, Kate!
Move the weapon!
It's okay. Oh. Wait for your fish. Wait for your fish, Kate.
Let's go. Oh, no! No way! No, go! Go!
Irma Pence.
Q, Q, Q. Corina's Quirrell. Okay, Rebecca, sweetie, it's time to go.
Okay. Wow. You know your Harry Potter.
There's a lot of downtown in a flower shop. And I love to read.
What's your favorite?
You know what? I don't have one. I pretty much love them all.
Yeah, me too. So, you into the Mercenary Fables?
No, I never read them. Should I check them out?
Oh, definitely. They're awesome.
Okay, I will. Thanks for the tip.
So, be on for tomorrow? Hey, Dad?
What's up?
Can I hang out with Rebecca at the mall tomorrow afternoon?
I don't see why not. We've got to go for the flowers tomorrow, right?
Right.
Yeah, sure, no problem.
Cool. I'll walk you to your car.
I'll walk you to your car.
Tyler seems like a great kid.
You sure made a great first impression.
Come on, a Harry Potter game? Like fastballs. Right in my wheelhouse.
Well, maybe we could all go for a double date sometime.
Maybe. I should get going.
You played great today.
Thanks. Me too. I'll see you tomorrow.
Yo.
Yeah, we gotta go.
Okay.
Sweet.
You like it?
Yeah.
You inspired me. What the hell? Wendy.
Gavin, Kate told me you were in town.
What happened?
Fire. We'll be open again soon. I just need to get some documents from the safe.
But Wendy, you don't have to say it. I know what you're thinking. I had no right to come back here like this and make a play for Kate.
Something like that.
I guess the thing is, I love Kate. I love her, and I'll do whatever it takes to win her back.
You have always been determined, Gavin. At least you recognize that it's a game.
So do you know anything about her new boyfriend?
Yeah, he's a friend of mine.
Well, tell me about him.
Yeah.
Hey, Kate.
Hi.
Hey, Dan. Gavin Malone.
Pleasure.
Nice to meet you. I'm an old friend of Kate's. Wendy told me about the fundraiser and obviously all the great work you guys do, and I just thought I'd come by and see if I could help.
Could always use another hand.
Great. I already grabbed this card.
Let's do it.
Okay, let's do it.
He looked like a football player or something.
A jock?
Yeah, a total jock.
Dude,
you can't compete with him.
I didn't know I was competing.
What am I gonna do? Dump her. But I really like her.
She's a two-timer, dude. Two-timers are bad news.
She keeps texting me.
What does she say?
Where are you? Are you coming? Are you okay?
How did you answer?
I didn't.
Good. Make her sweat. Serves her right.
I guess.
You know, I still can't figure out what a hedge fund is.
It's pretty simple, actually. You know, we provide alternative investment strategy that works to mitigate loss and preserve capital.
Now I'm really lost. You do that from home? The office? What?
Oh, I work out of my office down in L.A.
I thought you lived here.
Not anymore.
You're the axe.
You're the new guy.
Hey, Carney said that we could keep the flowers in cold storage till the afternoon of the ball. And he offered a 15% discount as a donation to the scholarship fund.
That's great.
Fantastic. Nice job.
I'm gonna go get another card.
This is so not cool.
Well, I was just sizing up my competition.
Did you follow me here?
All's fair in love.
Look, if this is your strategy for winning me back, you better think again.
Hey! You're right. I'm sorry. Take care of yourself.
Wait. Gavin. It sounded like goodbye.
Look, I shouldn't have come back here. It was selfish of me to think that we could just pick up where we left off. Like, that you'd even want to.
I don't know what I want.
I see the way it looks at you. It's pretty hard to miss. I mean, it's the way you used to look at me.
Don't go, okay? Not yet. I need a little time to figure this out.
Will you have dinner with me tomorrow night?
You're here. I was so worried. Are you okay? What is it? What's wrong? You're freaking me out.
I saw you at the mall. With that boy.
Boy?
You were talking to him. You took his number. You were...
Wait. You came to the mall? And you just left?
Well, yeah. I mean, I saw
you
guy.
Did you get my text?
Yeah.
And you just ignored them? Wow, Tyler. Wow.
Oh, wait! No! Rebecca! Hey! Please don't go. I'm sorry, okay? I'm really, really sorry.
You stood me up, Tyler. That is so not right.
I know. I'm an idiot. It's just, I don't know what I'm doing here. I've never done this before.
Done what before?
Had a girlfriend. A Valentine.
Well, neither have I, but I'm absolutely positive this is not how you treat her.
I saw you flirting with that guy.
I wasn't flirting.
He was flirting with you then, and you didn't seem to mind. Look, I shouldn't have ditched you like that, and I shouldn't have ignored your texts. I had no excuse except I was jealous.
maybe I was flirting with him. He goes to my school, and all the girls crush on him. And he's never paid any attention to me, and I thought it was cool that he was.
Well, of course he was. You're amazing.
I guess when you're somebody's Valentine, you probably shouldn't flirt with other guys.
I mean, I don't want you not to talk to other guys or, you know, like them. I just don't want you to like them as much as you like me.
I don't. I couldn't.
Definitely trouble in paradise.
Yeah, I think you're right.
I guess if things don't work out, she'll quit the team.
Don't think like that. I totally understand. Don't worry. It's not a problem.
I thought I was over him. I was over him. And now I'm not so sure.
I was in love with somebody for a long time, too. I get it.
I'm really confused.
Well, that's why I should take myself out of the situation.
But I don't want you to.
Yeah, listen. Our time together has been really nice. But you should probably focus on what's happening with you and Gavin. Having me in the middle is just gonna complicate everything.
What about our Valentine date?
Don't worry about that. You're off the hook. So you got jealous?
I guess.
You guess? You saw her at the mall with another boy, you jumped to the wrong conclusion, and you did a number on yourself.
Myself? What do you mean, myself? I was angry at her.
Well, she didn't know that until you told her. You were the one that was getting all bent out of shape, right?
Yeah, you're right. And it stinks, by the way.
Jealousy does stink. And it can be very destructive.
Were you ever jealous with Mom?
Of course, especially in the beginning. But you know, if you really care about somebody and you grow to trust them, then you learn to let that kind of thing go.
Good. Because I don't ever want to feel like that again.
To be honest with you, I was jealous just today. A little bit. With Kate.
Really? Why?
Because her old boyfriend's back in town and he decided to drop in on us when we were shopping for flowers. And it really bugged me.
She's two-timing you?
Where'd you pick up a phrase like that, huh?
Alex.
Ah, the relationship expert. Now, she was with him for a long time. I just happened to meet her on the rebound.
So, I guess she's not your girlfriend anymore?
She never really was my girlfriend.
Hmm. What about this?
I guess I won't. Needing that, right?
It's too bad. She's cool.
Yeah, she is pretty cool. Hey, Sal.
Hey, Dan.
Chels?
Dan? How's it going?
Good, how you doing?
Good.
I got a question for you.
Mm-hmm.
You're a woman.
Noticed.
Look, I don't have a lot of experience at these kinds of things. Laura and I met when we were just kids.
Kate broke up with you.
Yeah.
Why?
Her old boyfriend's back in town.
Ah, okay, so she said she didn't want to see you anymore.
Actually, she said she was confused.
What did you say?
I told her I should just get out of the way.
So you broke up with her?
Yeah, technically, yeah.
I don't know, Dan. If I said to someone I was confused, I'd be saying, I want to talk to you about this. I want you to help me not be confused.
So you actually might want to still see them?
If I didn't want to see someone anymore, I would just say it. If I said I was confused, that doesn't mean I don't want to see you anymore. Got it?
Yeah.
So you ready?
I don't think I can do this.
Come on, I can't do it alone. Why not? It's a two-person thing. So get Rebecca to do it. Dude, it's a surprise. That's the point. buy her a box of chocolates or something. That'll surprise her. Come on, I'm going to a ball with her. I'll look lame if I can't dance. Things were way cooler before you had a girlfriend. Come on. Get up here, man. I'll owe you one. You won't tell anybody about this? Of course not. All right. But I will not waltz, okay? Why not? I just don't like the sound of it. Fine, whatever. All right? No waltzing.
What do we got?
Hotel downtown.
One suite. Oh my god. I better get this girl for this.
We got that 4th and Cameron, south side of the building. 4th and Cameron?
Got a live one, Joey.
Copy that.
Lieutenant Farrell, I got pump 26, aerial 16 staging on the south side, seaside. I got smoke visible.
Good?
I'm good. All right, you guys roll along. We're gonna go check it out. Could you come with me?
Got it.
I'm set, let's go.
All right, guys, we can do this.
Stop now, fellas, let's move. Let's go.
We did near the end, scene 3.
Yeah, that was super fun.
Walt,
no way.
Way.
Hold on.
Hello?
Hey, buddy, it's Joey.
Hi, Joey.
Listen, your dad had an accident at work.
What happened?
Don't worry.
He's gonna be fine. We just gotta get him to the hospital to make sure. He'll be at home as soon as they release him. Okay, Tyler.
Talk to you soon.
What's wrong? It's my dad.
Hey, what happened in there?
It's a mask malfunction.
Oh, thank God for the man down system.
It's weird. You're up there gasping for breath. You think about some pretty scary things.
Like your life flashing before you?
I wasn't thinking about me. I was thinking about Tyler.
All right, let's get you out of here.
Hey, Wendy.
Okay.
Tell me everything.
Well, there's really not much to report.
Gavin couldn't have been more charming.
Did he ask you to marry him again?
No. No, we just talked. It was nice.
You still mad at me for telling him about Dan?
Furious.
Kate. He got to me. The thing is, remember how I told you about me and Nick and that little hiccup we had in our relationship back in the day? Yeah. It was me.
I thought it'd be a good idea for us to see other people, which was a monumentally bad idea. And after 3 months of that, I was desperate to get things back to normal.
So I kind of identify with what Gavin's going through.
Wow. Wow, I mean, Gavin is being awfully sweet.
And he's really trying to make it about us and not him.
So then maybe you guys will get back to normal, too. So you have plans for Valentine's Day?
Yes, he managed to get us a reservation at Chez Georges.
Ooh, and you can even pronounce it. Wow, expensive, romantic, and extremely hard to get into.
He is being really sweet.
You didn't eat very much.
Yeah, not very hungry.
You usually inhale carbon air.
I know, but I think I might still be feeling the effects from the smoke.
So, after this, do you want to play some Wii?
I don't think so, buddy. I'm pretty beat.
So, do you want to watch some of our shows? We're way behind.
Not tonight. I'm gonna pass.
Dad! Snap out of it!
Snap out of what?
Okay. I know you really like Kate. I mean, duh, everybody knows that.
We've talked about it already. This is not gonna happen with Kate.
You're moping, Dad.
Moping.
You seem like one of those walking dead.
Hey, Kate, it's Dan. I'm sorry I missed you. Listen, there's something okay. When I said to you the other day that I really enjoy spending time with you, it was an understatement. I just really wanted you to know that I really love spending time with you, and I'm a firefighter, you know. I fight, and I just wanted you to know that I want to fight for you. Okay.
Delete message, press 7. To save message, press 9.
Dan?
What are you doing out of bed?
I heard you talking. It woke me up. Was that Kate?
Yeah, her voicemail.
I'm glad you called her, Dad.
I deleted the message.
Why? You like her. She should know that.
Well, it's not that simple.
Well, sure it is.
When you get older, things get a little bit more complicated. You're just a little too...
Don't say it, Dad. Don't say I'm too young to understand. I like a girl too, you know. I know what you're going through.
I appreciate that.
Look, I'm not trying to give you a hard time. It's just you've really helped me out with Rebecca. I want to return the favor.
Get over here. You want to do me a favor? You make sure you get a good night's sleep tonight, okay? Because you're gonna need to be on your A game if you want to sweep this girl off her feet tomorrow. You got it?
But you shouldn't have deleted that message. And you should let Kate know how you feel.
Got it.
You have no new messages in your mailbox.
Which way are you leaning?
Sure was. Dark or light?
Let's see. I don't know. I can't really decide.
You know what Rebecca's wearing?
Dress, I guess.
Yeah. What color dress?
I don't know.
Because you don't want to clash.
Wow, you're really into this.
Yeah. I want you to look good for your girlfriend.
I thought you thought girlfriends were lame.
Maybe not so much as I used to. I mean... If Rebecca wanted to, you know, introduce me to one of her friends or something, that'd be cool.
I guess I'll see what I can do.
Hey, Chief, I'm gonna head out and make sure everything's all set up for tonight, okay? I should be back around 5.
Okay, but Dad, did I tie this right? And do you like the color?
Well, the knot's a real hatchet job, but yeah, color's great.
Are ties always supposed to choke you?
You notice your old man never wears one? Try the open collar with a sport coat. It's a great look.
Cool. All right.
And I'm back at 5. Don't be late.
All right, later.
You should try to come tonight. It's a fun event.
Well, thanks. We like to stay in on Valentine's Day, you know, have a nice romantic dinner at home.
Sounds nice.
Well, this will be our 43rd.
It's a good run.
We're not anywhere near done yet. Not if I can help it. What about you and Kate?
Oh, no.
Aren't you?
No, we're just friends.
Oh. Well, have fun tonight.
You too.
Okay. See ya.
Seriously, she tried on like a dozen dresses before she found the one she liked.
You're kidding me. What a riot. When I left this morning, Tyler was trying on suits.
Aww.
That's unheard of.
Aww. Well, they may not be destined for each other, my friend, but I cannot imagine a better first boyfriend for my why must you grow up so fast daughter.
That's very sweet of you to say. You never know.
No, never know. These arrangements, look at them, they're knockouts. Kate really has an eye, huh?
She sure does.
Hey, sorry things didn't work out with you guys.
It's okay. I'm cool. Listen, I'm gonna go home and get all gussied up. See you tonight.
See you tonight.
See ya. Great guy like that should not be alone on Valentine's Day.
He won't be. He'll be with us.
Which makes it worse.
Infinitely.
Well, we saved his life once before. There's no reason we can't do it again.
No, ma'am. No reason at all.
It's been so long since I've seen your face.
Hi, Gavin.
It's been so long.
Yeah, 7:30 sounds great.
I will be ready.
Me too.
But I'm not complaining, only explaining what makes us stronger. It makes us.
Motley Crue,
Betty Joan,
and a dress even. Looks good.
We'll still be together.
Happy Valentine's Day.
Oh, with the love like ours, you know that we'll never lose.
Oh, Tyler! These are so cool.
Your mom told me your size. I figured that they'd look good with your red belt when you get it.
Thank you. I got you something, too. I know it's not until Memorial Day.
The premiere of the Mercenary Fables movie?
Sorry for making you wait. Here you go. You would just sign next to your name, number 20.
Where's Kate?
She and my dad broke up.
Oh, no. Why?
Something about an old boyfriend. But it stinks, because my dad really likes her. I heard him leave a long message telling her that.
At least she knows how he feels.
Yeah, but she doesn't.
Why not?
Dad deleted the message. If there had been an undelete option, I think he would have taken it.
An undelete option. That'd be pretty cool.
Hey, Joey.
How are we going? All right.
Hello, dear.
Dan, you remember my sister, Serena?
Hi.
Serena. wow.
Good to see you.
You too.
Well, are you going to paddle me?
Right. You're number 19?
You know what? This could be fun. So, your sister's gonna bid on me. This could be really fun.
Thank you.
Wendy, thank you for coming.
Good to see you. Sign me up.
Thought you were...
Mary? Yup. I'm just trying to keep things interesting. Just kidding.
Okay.
I was here a couple of years ago and it got down to one serious bidder who walked away with a dream date for a song. I'll make sure that doesn't happen again.
Perfect. I love that. You're number 60.
You know, Kate isn't just my business partner. She's my best friend. She tells me pretty much everything. In high school, I thought you were a great guy. Lo and behold, you still are.
Thank you.
This is Tyler Farrow.
Hi, Tyler.
We need to talk.
No, no.
My favorite. You remember?
How could I forget? Open it.
You should wait till after dinner.
No. Open it. Here we go again. Kate Burlingham. Will you marry me?
Okay, let's do this.
All right, bring it in. Listen to me, I'm gonna be on the mic working the room, okay? Now, sometimes these bids are shout-outs, but a lot of times the ladies just raise their paddles, so I need you to be my spotters.
Yep.
If there's a bid that I don't see, you gotta let me know.
Okay,
cool. All right, I'm counting on you.
Cool.
Pound it.
Pound it.
A change of plan. What change of plan? Dan is not going to be dateless on Valentine's Day.
Ladies and gentlemen, can I have your attention, please? Normally you would say ladies and gentlemen, but for this next part, the fellas have nothing to do with it. That's right, that's right. The moment you've all been waiting for, we're about to auction off date night with one of Manchester's bravest. The hot, the sexy, the one and only Mr. Hollywood himself, firefighter Michael Carrier. Just give us a minute, please. Thank you. Was it something that he ate?
I don't know, but it came up fast.
Michael's sick.
As a dog.
Think.
Michael, are you okay?
No.
He can't go on the auction block like that.
He has to.
No, you want him to hurl on bidders?
And we need a replacement.
Like who?
No way. What about you?
Oh, that's Dash? Sorry.
I'm not doing it. No, 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 no,
no, no, no, no.
It's for the scholarship fund, eh?
Thank you for your patience, everybody. Due to unforeseen technical difficulties,
Michael Carrier will not be able to serve as our auction prize tonight. I know. No, I'm sorry. Not to worry. We have a substitute. And this being on a date with one of our bravest, I can tell you from personal experience that there are none other braver than our very own Lieutenant Dan Theron. Come on, big guy. Get out of here. I've got 50. Who's going to make it 100? Do I hear 100?
100 right here.
I got 100. Do we make it 200?
200.
Got 200. Do I hear 300?
300.
Excellent. We've got 300. Do I hear
2,000? Come on, people. Let's get serious here. Look at this fine specimen of man we have.
He's right. He speaks the truth.
Twenty-one, going once.
22.
22, I've got 22.
23.
23, I've got
3,500.
Full of surprises.
She can't bid. She doesn't have a paddle.
She does now. Thank you.
Okay, well, just so you know, I got a huge settlement in my divorce.
Huge.
Good for you.
But just so you know, I bought 1,000 shares of Apple back in 97 and held on to them.
Hello. All right. We've got $3,500. Do I hear 36?
36.
36.
37. 38.
39.
4,000.
5,000 dollars.
Wow. Well, you really want this.
Oh, yeah. When I make up my mind, I make up my mind. She's a lucky woman.
Going once. 5,000 going twice. Sold for $5,000! That is a world record! Woo! Way to go, buddy!
Woo! I know I paid for this, so it's kind of a sure thing, but Dan Theron. Will you be my Valentine?
Why didn't I know?
Where was I standing when the earth was just below?
Well, it's been a lifetime and it's way, way overdue.
Thank you.
got it.
Come on, Chelsea, we're up.
Saddle up. What is it?
Commercial. Slow burn.
Okay.
Got a flower shop, 2217 Sudbury, west of Manchester. 15 seconds to liftoff. Moving out here. Let's move and chop chop. Let's go.
Aerial 16 on scene, A side, west side, heavy smoke showing.
It's our shop.
Anybody else inside?
No,
this is Chelsea, our paramedic. She's gonna take care of you. Get them back away from the building, okay?
Got it.
I got O2.
I just heard this pop in the cold storage unit, and there was suddenly all this smoke, but no flames.
Hey, no unusual redness. It's good.
We got out of there fast.
Smart. You ladies crawl out?
No.
Okay. Well, if you're ever in that situation again, hit the floor, get on your hands and knees. Most casualties in a fire, happy with smoke inhalation. But you don't see that coming.
Let's go around back. Smoke.
Sounds good. You ladies sit tight, all right?
All right, thank you.
Oh, here we go.
You got lucky. Fire's in the flower storage unit, but we contained it there.
So there's no fire damage?
Well, the compressor's toast. And that ethylene couldn't be good for your flowers, but it's no structural damage.
Great. Just what we need with Valentine's Day around the corner.
At least you're safe.
Thank you.
Are you Dan Farrell?
Yeah.
Wendy. Wendy Clark. You were in my big brother's class at Chatham High.
Stephen Clark. How many years has it been?
Oh, let's not do that math. This is my business partner, Kate Burlingham.
Hi.
Sorry about the circumstances. Pleasure to meet you.
Me too. Thank you.
Hey. Say hi to Steven, all right?
Yeah.
Saddle up, fellas. Get back to the shop.
Shall we face the music?
I don't think we have a choice. Dan Farrell. Such a great guy in high school. Found out at a reunion that his wife died a few years ago.
Oh.
Laura Holloway, she was in my brother's class too.
That is so awful.
Yeah, can't imagine.